Hi, I'm drummer Snappy Smith, and welcome to lesson 4 of my couch series. Again, you and me on a couch with a practice pad, going over those basic exercises and lessons as taught to me by Freddie Gruber. And in lesson 4, we're going to be covering the flam. This is mainly page 40 through 42 of the Buddy Rich book. And the flam, of course, is just, I think, one of the all-time great rudiments. Freddie's approach, as always, was more of a hands-down approach. So with the flam, it was no different. And he had me use more of an arm movement. So it would be kind of the main basic beginning exercise was coming up on the ands. One, and, two, and, three, and, four, and, one, and, two, and. Both alternating and just, you know, left or right hand leads. And, you know, part of this is not just a real strict arm movement. A key to what was really taught was that as the arm lifted, the hand released a little bit. So a little bit of this kind of release motion. So as the arm comes up, the wrist relaxes, and you get this motion here. It's a different kind of stroke, isn't it, than your typical up-down stroke here, or everything being wrist. It's more, and just to kind of a little aside, you know, as I kind of learned, a lot of what this feels like is kind of no different than if you're walking, taking steps. You kind of lift and relax your foot, relax and take a step. It's like you're walking, just walking along, relaxing. Lift, as you lift your arm or your leg, your foot or your wrist relaxes and you step. So then you take that into your flams. See how easy that is? That's a relax. It's an arm movement, but that wrist gives you a little bit of a whip motion. So now we're into, I'm going off on the side from the flams. We'll get back to the flams. But this is kind of really key because this is used for certain accents in the flams later on. So I want to cover now what would be called the whip motion. And again, it's lifting the arm, relaxing the wrist, but a little bit of a back arm or elbow movement. So you're getting this whip. It's kind of the opposite of what I taught you before, where it was that kind of tap, that up forward down motion. Well, this is more back into the side to get this whip. And you can get a lot of power out of this with just a very little motion. So let's get back to flams. So here we are, we're doing our flams, and again, mainly an arm motion coming up on and. One, and, two, and, three, and, four, and. And, and, and. Very little movement because less movement gives you, makes it possible to have more speed. All right, so now we're getting into the first flam paradiddle. So, of course, your basic paradiddle, one, up, tap, tap, up, tap, 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 down, tap, up, tap, tap. Except rather than exaggerating that up motion, it's going to be a little more of just a simple arm up motion. We add the flam. Okay, and then we go into the double flam paradiddle. So same concept. I'm stopping there because I want you to notice something. Notice how my stick's kind of a little bit of an upward angle. It's not straight, it's coming up a little bit. You're going to notice in the double and triple paradiddles especially, of course, we have a kind of a constant released a stroke going on. Now, when we do that up motion, right? As I'm coming up, it's a little bit of that kind of forward, kind of whip motion, and coming down. As we come down, we're going into our, and so you want to kind of really go into that kind of fulcrum wrist bounce. So that's why when you make that first downward, you want to let the stick pop up a little bit and then carry through. And you may want to kind of start a kind of just a preliminary exercise of doing just your wrist bounces. See, there's a weight shift. See? And you keep in mind, you know, these rudiments were all made for marching parade drummers. So a lot of the reason for the alternating sticking was to kind of coordinate with their leg movements or their marching right, left, right, left. So you have to kind of shift your torso weight, your body weight, especially when you're playing on a kit, you know, to go with these paradiddles. So of course, then we get into the triple paradiddle, you know. See, so when you're doing when your right hand is leading, notice how now I've kind of actually, this hand is actually kind of a little bit of a forward tilt. And then when this is leading, it's more of an open. And this opens up kind of an interesting thing that I figured out, because I used to watch Buddy's videos, and he could do, you know, these really fast just flams, succession of flams, and it was like, how's he doing that without tightening up? Well, you know, one good observation that I made was that you know, when you're bouncing your sticks together, you know, they're all hitting in unison, you got a good kind of balanced, kind of even hit where they're hitting in unison. If you just lift one stick a little bit and shift the weight forward, it causes that stick to hit a little ahead of the time. And it kind of shortens the stroke. The weight shift makes the stick hit a little bit ahead of the beat. So you don't have to do much to turn a basic you know, double hit in unison into a flam. The kind of a cool thing. Don't think I'm playing a bunch of flams. Just keep your sticks relaxed and just lift that one arm and make that your grace note. So we've covered single, double, triple paradiddles. Then we get into the flam tap. And this is where we again would use kind of a fulcrum wrist bounce. And you can do that as a 6-8. Now the 6-8 is a little different. Because now you're doing more of a release upstroke. See? So when you're doing the even flam tap, you're just coming down. And now, see, I'm still doing an arm movement. Even though I'm coming up with my wrist, it's kind of an arm wrist thing. So it's... When I go into a 6-8 flam tap, it's a little bit more of a released wrist. Moving on to page 42. And now we are doing, flam accents. So flam accents, we're gonna start with the 2-4 version, which is basically 1, Andy, 2, Andy, 3, Andy, 4, Andy, 1, Andy, 2, Andy, 3, Andy, 4. So the language for this would be flam, up, tap, flam, up, tap, flam, up, tap, flam. So we're using that motion again. And this is, you can really dig this. I mean, I love that, just pump, up, tap, pump, pump, and up. It's just such a subtle motion. Let your body get into it. Let your arms relax, and just have it be from your shoulder. And just that. And the 6-8. Of course, you need to do a Swiss triplet. And then we get into the flammacue. Flammacues are actually pretty hip, especially because, as it's shown here, it has that accent. It's and this kind of introduces a new movement that Freddie had me use, which is called the whip snap movement. So basically, we talked about a whip being a little bit of a backward kind of release, arm release. Now a snap is more of a, it's more from a down position already, and it's just that. It's more just a release right into closed position. So with the flammacue, to kind of break it down, it would be, starting with my right hand lead, a whip motion, whip, with a flam, whip, and then a snap. So it's whip, snap, up, tap, down. 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 See? Now dig this. This is because as I'm the grace note for my flam is coming up, and that's preparing me for my snap. So it's... When you work it out, it has a great feel to it. All right, so that was flams, and you know, while we got some time, we might as well kind of take a little look at drags, because it's kind of a similar kind of a vibe to it, you know, rather than just your single grace note. Now, the drag, of course, you're doing that, you're going to release and get that double. So it's in, you want that kind of, that arm movement, because it, as that arm's coming down, everything's happening within that space of time. That, so you almost kind of want to kind of up, up, and let it drop. And kind of, I'm kind of doing this as it releases. I'm kind of coming up, and I'm actually kind of squeezing it here. So I'm really pulling it out. And this sets up another cool movement, which is called the pop and drop. And the way this would work was lifting the arm back, kind of that whip motion, but letting the stick come up and then drop down. Which is actually the first two beats of the molar. So it's just that, but again, using that kind of inertia and that and those physics of just that kind of pulling that stick back, dragging it a little bit, letting the weight tilt, and then coming down into a pop, and then dropping it down. So I'm looking at less than 54 here, like the single drag. And in the 6/8 version, it'll be like, so, as I'm coming up from my drag, it's preparing me for my whip motion into a pop. See? And then that comes down for your next downbeat. What else we got here for drags? Well, here's you know, a lot of these. Of course, we got the that's the double drag. So we can do drags with our paradiddles, just like our flams. Thank you. regular paradiddles, flam paradiddle, rag. I'm doing this. It's a little bit of a forward. Coming, really coming down with the arm from the downbeat. So this is what you notice when you're getting more into, you know, flams and drags and roughs, is that it's going to start tightening your hands up, your grip up more, to get those fine little subtle beats out. So you want to make sure you've really established a good, relaxed approach initially in your basics, your fulcrum wrist bounces in your fingers. So everything is relaxed. So as you tighten things up, even though you're gripping the stick hard, more tightly, there's still fluidity and looseness in there. And you can find that, you know, especially when you're going faster, you know, all the movements are really just in this small little space. There's not a lot of big movements. I know a lot of guys are into like big showy movements and stuff, but you watch the great jazz drummers and Buddy Rich and Louie Belson and those guys, man, everything was down in here. Everything was a very small, you know, subtle motion. That's where it was, relaxed. Yeah, and as long as you got a good, open, relaxed sound out of the drum, you get a lot of projection. You don't need a lot of big motion to get volume. You can do a lot just in here. If you really use the physics of the stick and really, you know, get that, you know, that that movement where you just are really able to play with the stick in your hand and you've got that relaxed use of the stick, then you can really do some cool things with it and let the stick do all the work, and you're just manipulating it and juggling with it and bouncing with it. So I think that was a pretty good lesson. I'm pretty spent. And we covered flams, we covered the drags. I think you guys got a pretty good idea of kind of what the approach is. You can probably play with it all you want. But that will wrap up lesson 4 of the Couch Series with Snappy Smith. Till next time, you keep it snappy.